Netflix releases trailer for I Am Vanessa Guillen documentary. This could really be the end of the United States Army. Can the Army survive? I mean, they can bury the body. They can ignore the case. They can, you know, do whatever they want to do. They can have all these soldiers killing each other on bases. They can just pretend like all that doesn't exist and then release the Emma commercial and say everything's all good. But can the Army survive a Netflix documentary? I'm just going to throw this out there. My opinion? No. Nobody can survive a Netflix documentary. If there's one thing that you should really be terrified of, it's when Netflix comes after you with a high-profile, well-produced documentary or documentary series. We're going to watch the trailer for it now. The film follows her family's fight for historic military reform, a journey that takes them all the way to the Trump White House after the brutal murder story of their sister sparked a moment of reckoning for the U.S. military and the way it handled sexual assault investigations. Let's jump over and react to it. This, folks, is the I Am Vanessa Guillen documentary.
Her case is grabbing headlines across the nation. People want to know, where is Vanessa Guillen?
Where's my sister? They know where she is, and I want them to speak up.
This was not one of those cases the military can sweep under the rug.
Vanessa's always been the bravest of all of us. Something was wrong with her the few months after she was stationed at Fort Hood.
Not being able to sleep, losing weight. She would tell me that things weren't what they seemed.
Dijo si he sido acusado por un superior ahí en Fort Hood. Es una obra de corrupción, de maldad.
I called the staff sergeant. He's like, we don't know anything about her. You guys don't have cameras, nothing. And they were like, no.
The military did not give a damn.
Fort Hood seems to cultivate the worst of the worst.
A lot of missing soldiers, a lot of dead soldiers, a lot of bad there.
She's in the army. She's supposed to be safe there.
Ya traté yo y nada le dije, ¿cómo? Estos animales, dije, no me van a buscar a mi niña. Yo he de buscar a mi hija yo.
The Guillen family were not going to stay quiet.
The Hispanic culture is the sleeping giant, and the Guillen family woke it up.
People using my sister as a resemblance of themselves.
Hashtag I am Vanessa Guillen. I remember saying she is us.
It kept going and growing.
Sexual assault scandals are the new norm for the military.
Clearly an epidemic.
We had no other choice but to go and fight for legislation under my sister's name.
The military counts on survivors and their families staying quiet, and they miscalculated dramatically.
If we got Congress to listen, then we can get Congress to pass the bill.
This is our last chance. They do not support the full Vanessa Guillen Act. We have to really push on them.
This is not a Republican, Democratic issue. This is not a race issue. This is a human issue, so it should be everyone's issue.
Wow. Coming out November 17th, coming out next weekend. Will you guys be tuning into that? So when you hear about Denisha Montgomery, when you hear about these stories of soldier-on-soldier crime, you can't help but now think about Vanessa Guillen, who, you know, if you guys don't remember, she had gone to the armory to take care of some business at the end of a day where she was attacked and murdered by a soldier who then conspired with his not wife, but like girlfriend, even though he was married, to go bury the body off base. And they didn't find her for months and they weren't even really looking for her. Then I do want to remind you guys too, that after the Vanessa Guillen case, the Army officially said in a statement, the worst thing about the Vanessa Guillen case was how the PR was handled. They said the worst part about the Vanessa Guillen case was how the PR was handled. And if that doesn't make your eyeballs fall out of your head with shock, I don't know what will. But then also, even more damning, investigators had gone in and said any competent investigator should have been able to solve the Vanessa Guillen missing persons case basically immediately, calling out the Army CID as totally incompetent. So I wonder what stones will be unturned, what facts will be uncovered in this Vanessa Guillen documentary. But if there's one thing that I hope is that the Army cannot turn a blind eye to all the deaths within the ranks of soldier-by-soldier crime, hundreds of soldiers being killed on base by their battle buddies in gang-related violence and off-base killings in DUIs and getting arrested for human trafficking at the border, being recruited off TikTok to go do human trafficking on the border. All these horrible, absolutely insane things that are currently happening with the military, especially the Army, because of where they're stationed and the culture within the Army. It just, it's got to stop being just ignored and pretending like everything's fine. It's nuts. It's insane. So let me know what you guys think about that trailer in the comment section down below. Good, bad, ugly. Will the Army survive it? You let me know.
What's up, guys? Thanks for watching that video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and hit that subscribe button up in the corner here and check out this next video. If you want, in the description down below, there's links where you can get Scuttlebutt Show merch and find out how you can support the channel. I really appreciate it, and I look forward to talking to you guys very soon.